Mowing the lawn is one of the simplest things you can do in lawn care. Pretty much everybody does it, except for my neighbor, like three houses down. But even though it is simple, there are a few tricks that you can do to make sure that your lawn stays super healthy and that you don't undo any of that hard work you've been doing on your lawn to make it the nicest in the community. Now, welcome back to my channel. My name is Seth. This is the Secret Garden YouTube channel. Thank you very much for joining. Please, if you haven't yet, smash that like button, subscribe to my channel, it helps out a lot. And now, let's get started. Now, if you follow my channel, you might notice something different. There's a tree missing. Somebody stole it. Okay, maybe I cut it down. So I'm going to have a new video coming out soon. Look out for that one on why I cut this tree down. It's actually a pretty interesting conversation, I think. So stick around for that. Make sure you subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell so you're notified when I put this video out, probably in about a week or two. Now, the biggest mistake people make when mowing their lawn is not mowing it often enough. Now, I know we all are super busy. We got a lot going on, but you don't want to just mow your lawn whenever you come home from work and you see, oh, man, it's starting to get really long. Now I might want to cut it. We really want to cut it regularly. We want to cut our lawn every single week, really during the peak when it's growing really well during the heat of the summer. We really want to make sure we cut it every single week. Now, the big key on that and the reason why that is because first, you want to train your grass to start growing out. You don't want it to be growing higher and higher. You want it putting the effort into growing horizontally instead of vertically. And so we want to cut it often, but also we want to keep, and because of that, we want to keep our grass a little bit lower instead of letting it get too high. But also any time that you cut off too much of your grass at one time, it could actually damage it. So for example, if you let your grass get a good, 5 or 6 inches tall and then cut it off, you're cutting over half potentially of that grass down. That really will put a shock into the grass and it really will hurt it. It'll make it get a lot, be able to get a lot more diseases and things that you really don't want. You want to be as nice and gentle to your grass as possible. Now, talking about that, we also want to make sure that our mower blade is as sharp as possible. I actually keep two blades so I can go get one cleaned or I can get one cleaned, or not cleaned, I'm sorry, get one sharpened. I have another one always sharpened and ready. Once that one gets dull, I'll put the other one on that's already been sharpened. Then I got time to sharpen the other one. You want to make sure you have a nice, clean cut on your lawn because, again, the same way that you cut too much of your grass, if you kind of just ripping at your grass, it would be a lot more susceptible to diseases and issues. And if you get a bunch of diseases, then you're going to have to watch another YouTube video on how to cure funguses and diseases in St. Augustine grass. And you shouldn't have to go watch another YouTube video. Let's just cut our grass every week. It really will make a big difference. So when dealing with how high you mow your grass, you want to mow it at about 2.5 inches, really in that 2.5 to 3 inches range. I currently mow my grass right at 2.5 inches. Now, you want to make sure you're very careful and you measure exactly where or your height for your mower. Make sure you're actually measuring, make sure you're actually mowing at 2.5 inches. So for example, if I mowed at the 2 setting of my mower, it'd be way lower than 2.5 inches and I'd really mess up my grass. My setting is at a 4, which is at the 2.5 inches, a 3 is at 2, and a 5 is at 3 inches. So I'm at right at a 4. So don't just go ahead and move it to a 2. You want to actually use a tape measure and measure where your blade is and where the ground is. Do it on a nice level area, like in your garage, for example, and make sure that you get it at the right height. Now, if you have not been mowing your grass at that height, let's say you've been mowing it at much higher, you actually want to gradually go down. You don't want to immediately scalp it. That's what it's going to feel like. If you've been mowing it really high, you got to gradually start mowing it lower so your grass gets used to it instead of being a big shock. Because again, you don't want to cut off 50%, even really 35, 40% of your lawn at one time. That's why you want to mow every week to only take a little bit off every time. Now, one quick tip on your height. One thing that you can actually do is during the winter months, when it's getting closer to the winter, you can actually let your grass get a little bit taller. So for mine, instead of doing a 4, when it gets to the winter months, I'll actually start mowing it at a setting 5 to be at 3 inches instead of 2.5 inches. Now, the reason why that is because in the winter months, there's less sun coming out. And so you're going to have less photosynthesis happening with your grass. So you want your grass to be a little bit longer to get more photosynthesis, more of the sun, more surface air to get more sun since there's less sun. Now, in the summer, when you have really nice full sun, you don't need as much because you have so much sun. So your grass can be a little bit shorter. And again, it's going to just be trained to start growing horizontally instead of vertically. Now, the type of mower that you use doesn't really matter. I actually use a battery operated one. You can look at it in the link description below if you want to, but it really doesn't matter. Now, the one thing I will note though, if you do use a battery operated one, you want to make sure that it is strong enough. The same way, the same reason why you want a really nice sharp blade, you need a strong mower so you're not just pushing and ripping that grass. You want a nice smooth cut. So you are going to get a battery operated one. You want to make sure it's at least 40 volts. You don't want to get one of those really, you know, 20, 30 one. You want it as strong as possible if you're going to go with a battery over a gas option. Now, it's good to get into a routine with anything. Like I talked about in the fertilizing thing, honestly, in grass, you want to have a nice fertilization schedule. Watering, I'll do a video on that soon. You want to have a nice watering schedule. You want the same thing with your mowing the lawn. You want to make sure you have a nice schedule. Like I said, once a week, if you have off on the weekends, then do every Saturday or Sunday, for example. And if you can time your watering to where you water the night or two nights previously, at least, you know, right before you mow. The reason why you want to do that, you obviously don't want a wet lawn when you mow the lawn. I'm not saying that, but you want to make sure your grass is as healthy as possible, standing up as straight as possible. You want to mow whenever your grass is as healthy as possible. If you really need to water bad, you don't want to mow until you've watered first to make sure your grass is really healthy. All your leaves are nice, big, broad leaves standing up straight really well before you mow, so you don't do any additional damage to your lawn. Now, last thing, the debate on if you should bag your clippings. So very simply, if you follow this and you mow your yard every single day, then you want to actually leave your grass clippings on the ground. You do not want to bag them because they will actually break down and give more nitrogen to the soil, adding a little bit more fertilizer, and it definitely helps out a lot. It even helps out with water retention, which is definitely a big plus. Now, if this is the first time you're doing this and your lawn is super long and you're cutting off more than you really should on your lawn, you really do, at that point, you want to bag it all up because you don't want to have too much grass clipping smothering your lawn, which would be a bad thing. But if you are mowing every single week, then you want to leave those clippings on the ground and it'll actually add nitrogen back to your lawn. Okay, thank you very much for joining me, everybody. I really do appreciate it. Like I said, well, the stump that you can't see that you are basically standing on right now, I'm going to do a video on that in the next couple of weeks, so look out for that. If you haven't yet, hit that like button. I really do appreciate it. Thank you very much. If you have questions, please comment below. I try to answer every question that I get, and have a great day.